Hello again, welcome to my channel. This is Sarah. This is a coloring book review for Fantastic Cityscapes. So here is the front cover. The dimensions of the book are 10 by 10 inches. Here is the back of the book. And the spine. Here's the illustrator. And the thickness. Book is glue bound. It's a nice intro here. And the information page over here. So the book is divided up into five different categories. One is called density, the second called bend, the third one called break, fourth one is zeppelins, and the last one, the fifth one, is imagine. So each of the cityscapes that you'll see in each of the sections kind of go along with the word that it's divided up into, almost like chapters. So paper quality in this book is printer paper quality. Nothing special really about the paper. It's a higher quality of printer paper, but nonetheless it still is printer paper. So you'll see in the density section here that it really is dense. Coloring these particular buildings in this section is going to be very difficult because there is so much intricately designed work, and I'm usually a fan of the more intricate coloring books. This is a bit much. For the size of the book, it's a bit much. You're going to have trouble coloring if you want individual colors for each of these lines. Let me bring it up here for a second. You can see that's going to be a bit of a problem getting your pencil or whatever medium you're using in these little cracks if you want the individual colors. Now what you can do for this book is kind of do an overall color of the building and then go back in and highlight certain areas, put light in the windows, that kind of thing, to add just a touch different color to each of the buildings. That's how I would color this book, because the images are just so intricately done. This book is glue bound. You'll see I'm having a bit of trouble getting the spine broke into here. Let me break this a bit better. There we go. So if you actually get the spine broken really well, and it is very difficult to bend that out, you'll see that the buildings line up very well in the crack and the crease of the book. This is something that some coloring books have a lot of problems with. So I am glad to see that they do line up very well to the buildings on either side of the page. These pages would be good for watercolor, coloring pencils, gel pens, ink pens, water-based mediums like gelatos, watercolor pencils, stuff like that. One thing I would not use in this book is the alcohol-based marker simply because the pages are two-sided. And you'll ruin the other side. I do like a lot of the perspective in this particular book. As you can see, some of these look like they're done from a helicopter or an airplane, and you're looking down on the city itself, which is a neat thing. I've not seen that in any of the other coloring books that I have. This seems to be the biggest section. The first section seems to be the biggest dents. Second section is bend. And you can see these designs in this particular section are a bit easier to color. Even if they looked like this back here, you can tell a distinct difference in the spacing of the lines and how you're going to be able to color differently in these than the others. Next section is break. Next section, zeppelins. The last section is imagine. And this section seems pretty thick as well. Not as thick as the first one, but it is pretty thick. Again, some neat perspective in this book. And there is no test page in this book. That's one thing I really like added to books. It really helps just kind of judging what type of medium you'll be able to use. So again, this was a flip through review for Fantastic Cityscapes. And this is the illustrator down here. And I will have that information down below in the description. Don't forget to subscribe over here. And thank you for watching. Happy coloring.